Today I'll be showing you a very pretty different look again. This is called the lucky green look because it involves green and a little bit of a black along with a nude lip again. So to start off, I will be using the MAC paint pot in groundwork, just taking a little bit on my ring finger and applying it all over the lid. Next, moving to eyeshadow, I'll be using this green. It's called Humid by MAC. Taking a little bit of it onto an angle shading brush. That's the Sigma medium angle shading brush in E70. Dabbing off the excess. Once we're done with the green, we'll move on to using the black. This is the black that I'll be using. It's called Carbon by MAC. And using a fluffy brush, which is a blending brush, just applying it at the outer corner of the eye and blending it like a V. Now after we're done with the black, we'll be using a color which is called All That Glitters from MAC again, just to blend out the lines that are visible to the naked eye. Taking a little bit on a dome shaped brush and very gently using it on the crease line just to haze out any prominent lines or marks that have remained, and using this above like a highlighter as well. Next, for the kajal, I'll be using the MAC engraved pencil. Now for the waterline, now that we've applied the kajal, just below that we'll apply a little bit of Carbon that we had used in the outer corner V. Just until 3/4 of the eye. Now for the inner quarter section, I'll be using the same green that we had used for the eyelid. For the eyeliner, I think I would like to give it a very diffused kind of a look. So I'll be using a pencil and then smudging it all over. I'm using Smolder by MAC and just drawing a very thin line. And then using the short shader brush by Sigma in E20, just evening it out. Next up, we'll be curling the lashes and applying a lot of mascara. For the mascara, I'm using the Maybelline Colossal Volume Express, applying it from above as well as from below. Wiggle the wand very well, that's the only way you'll get the curl. Now moving on to the face, I'll be using the MAC Prep Plus Prime Face Primer, massaging it between the two fingers. What it does is that it acts like a barrier between your skin and foundation. It makes your foundation last for really long, and also it makes its application much easier and smoother. For the foundation, I'll be using the MAC Studio Fix Fluid, taking a little bit of it on my palm and using a stippling brush, which is a duo fiber brush. This is the BND foundation brush, and just taking a little bit of it on its initial bristles and applying it downwards and then in rotated movements. Now the good thing about this brush is that it does not load on too much product on the brush or even on the face. And then when you're going circular movements, it spreads very evenly and it does not give a cakey look at all. Make sure to apply foundation on the fixed foundation. Now this is a foundation powder. This can be used by itself or over a liquid foundation. The best way to use it is during the day, just use it by itself because it contains foundation properties in it. In case if you feel that you want to do it up even more heavy, then use a liquid foundation and top it over with this. This generally comes with a sponge in this area, but in case if you feel you do not want to use the sponge because the coverage will be higher, use a brush and just buff it all over the face. So using a blush brush, which is a fluffy brush, just take a little bit of product, dab off the excess, and brush it all over the face. Now for the blush, I'll be using the MAC blush in the shade of Peach. If you closely look at Neha's face, she already has very, very sharp cheekbones. So the entire area over here, if I contour it more, her face is going to look even more longer and straighter. So I will leave the contour, but I will use a highlight. For the highlight, I'm using Vanilla by MAC. This is an eye pigment, but it can be used brilliantly as a highlighter as well. So just taking a little bit in case if you feel that the green is extremely dark for you, you can use a lighter green. If you feel you do not want to use the black, again customize it to your choice, do not use the black. And in case if you want to wear a lipstick, use a very nude lipstick like in shades of your skin color, maybe something as close to that, or just wear a lip balm and you can walk out and it'll look absolutely fine. So this is the lucky green look. I hope you guys have enjoyed. And I will see you very soon with another fresh new video. Thanks for watching.